What is an evap line when it comes to your pregnancy tests? Hi everyone, my name is Susan and this is the Awslims. Thank you so much for joining me today. So in this video, I'm gonna talk to you about what an evap line is, how it is created, and how you can try to avoid having an evap line on your pregnancy tests. So evap lines are sort of a false positive line that may appear on your pregnancy tests. These sort of lines can appear on, not on digital tests obviously, but on tests that use either a pink dye or blue dye. So these are tests that will have a control line and a test line. Your control line will always be, if the test is working properly, your control line will always be either pink or blue depending on what dye is in your test. And then your test line, what you're generally looking for is another pink or blue line to indicate that you are pregnant. But sometimes you will get something that is instead called an evap line, which is an evaporation line that appears and it looks to be a very faint line on your test line, but it's actually nothing. So this is where you get a lot of false positives in pregnancy test readings, because when it comes to pregnancy tests, even the faintest line will indicate that you are pregnant. So pregnancy tests are testing for a hormone called HCG, and this hormone is only present in your body when you are pregnant. So if you have this hormone in your body, even in very, very minute amounts, this indicates that you are pregnant, that an embryo has implanted into your uterus. So this is why even the very faintest line indicates a positive when it comes to pregnancy tests. But if you get one of these evap lines, that's when everything goes out the window. That's when your test is basically giving you a false positive if you don't know what you're looking for and you think that this evap line is a faint line. So evap lines or evaporation lines are basically just your urine evaporating from the test strip. And sort of this evaporation is causing sort of a shadow-like line to appear on the part of the test that is just the test strip, the test line part, so not on the control line. So this evap line won't be either pink or blue, it'll be more of like a gray, a light gray. So evaporation lines typically occur when you read the test too late. So typically you're supposed to read a pregnancy test between 5 and 10 minutes after the test has touched the urine. And if you read it any later than 10 minutes, generally they say do not read a test after 30 minutes. So if you read a test too late, then what has happened is that the urine can evaporate from the test, causing this evap line to appear. Evap lines can also appear if the test itself gets wet. So you know when you know how on little test strips it usually tells you the max amount to dip your strip into the urine. So if you go over that max amount and you splash urine or water or whatever onto the actual test lines, then this can also cause an evap line to occur. So can an evap line indicate a positive pregnancy test at any time? The answer is no. If there is an evap line, this means a negative pregnancy test every single time. So the test line, if it has no color in it, so no either pink or blue dye in it, then there is no HCG. So if there is a line, but it's just gray, that is the evap line. So that is a negative pregnancy test. So some ways to prevent evap lines from happening would be to, instead of peeing on the actual test strip, to pee into a cup and then dip the test strip into the cup, making sure that you do not go over the max line and just holding the strip in there for the proper amount of time that it says on your package, which is usually like 3 to 5 seconds. So by using a cup, this prevents the urine from splashing onto the test strip and possibly affecting it in that way. Also, another thing to do would be to not use a pregnancy test that is past its expiration date, as well as not storing pregnancy tests in either very hot or very cold conditions. These things might have an effect on the way that the tests read out. It might have an effect on the quality of the tests. So another thing, the very basic thing that you should be not doing in order to prevent an evap line is to obviously read the test before 30 minutes. So read it during the proper amount of time, which is about between 5 and 10 minutes after the test has absorbed your urine. So those are some things that you can do to prevent evap lines. Sometimes they say, especially with the blue dye tests, that even before the 5 to 10 minute mark, even if you're reading it before it's been 30 minutes, that evap lines can still occur in those cases. But basically what you need to know is that if there is any color on that test strip line, the faintest amount of blue or the faintest amount of pink, depending on which dye the test is, any faint amount of color, the smallest amount of color, indicates that you do have HCG levels in your body and therefore are pregnant. There are some cases where you know, you might see this very, very faint colored line, and then the next day you test again and there is absolutely no line. And this is not an evap line in this case. This would be something more like maybe a chemical pregnancy where, you know, you did have an embryo that implanted, but then your body decided that that embryo was just not developed enough to the point where it wanted to continue the pregnancy, basically. So maybe there were some abnormalities or something in the embryo where your body decided that, okay, this embryo is, you know, you're not going to continue with the pregnancy. Not getting into that too much, but basically it is where there was a fertilized egg that became an embryo that did implant, but now it is no longer implanted. So the important thing to look for basically is the color of this line that you are seeing. If it is gray, if it doesn't have any color, then that is an evap line. But if it is a little bit colored, then that is a positive pregnancy test. So I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Please subscribe to my channel for more tips and tricks and everything about trying to conceive and fertility and pregnancy. And I will see you again very soon. Thank you. Bye.